We are about to watch Backchat. Oh. Oma, Essa, Gogo, Titi, ah, Lucy, Luca,
Rufa,
Security, Security, yeah,
Crumpled Biscuit. I wish you would take that hair off and just be natural. Oh.
Yo, it's all going
oh my god, you know, I've got a story time with him. He, we went to buy the same Jordans when they were released, and he thought he could be VIP and come to the front, and they said he's asked in the back behind me. Tell them that story, West Willie. Yes. And you getting Brazilian butt lift, what message was that sending? Oh, arrange your child to be independent and modify their body.
Have a husband, get married. Now, if you start escorting yourself, you're like, naturally people are going to look upon you and think, rah, it's almost like prostituting, let's be fair.
No one even really knows when someone's an escort,
now,
for fuck's sake.
Possibly might say you're not doing is not sleeping with a guy, but I find that difficult to believe because no man's going to pay you to just escort him around.
Some men actually pay to be in the company of women.
Exactly.
It doesn't necessarily mean I want to sleep with them.
Exactly.
Some men I'm not confident enough to go out there and start, or they're too busy, for example.
Either way, for me personally, I think it's unacceptable. It's not, it doesn't send a great message to young
and
women.
You get what message did you send getting a Brazilian butt lift?
Gives that a bad reputation to the other women.
And you getting your butt lift? Just shut up. Would someone just take this goat back to the bum? I'm tired of her already talking. Give her some grass. Oh, look at Biscuit.
Friends that are hoes, they do that on the D-low. They don't, there's not a lot of people, like you said, people are not, you know, flamboyant about it. They don't show off about it. They like to discreetly do that. That's their own business. Now, if you're escorting, people are now being proud about it. They're walking around.
No, not necessarily.
Let me finish. They're snapping it. They're putting it on social media. They're doing all of those things. You're basically, you're being an open book about it. It's not acceptable.
That's a lie. And when you bought your bum, that's what you thought. You wanted to show it off, didn't you? What a hypocrite, actually. She's definitely a hypocrite, talking about what is given to young girls. And you?
Agencies or whatever, and they're escorts and they go out. Don't sleep with the guy they're going out with. They're just there for the purpose of being there.
Most people do. Most people don't, I mean.
In my own eyes, I call them cons.
You're an idiot.
They are the ones who say they are escorts or deny that they are escorts, but really they have sugar daddies. They're sleeping with even my people that are my
not family. Everyone is sleeping. I've got friends that get money from men and they've never even touched their lips. Ew. So don't say that, stupid girl.
So for me, professional escorts, sugar daddy escorts, you are all hoes.
That's a horrible thing to say, to be honest.
So escorting, in its technical term, is what you said, is a man or woman paying for...
I wish Nudie was here, I'd like to hear what she says to me
on this. Maybe like to take you and show you off at a dinner or something else, I don't know what the proposal is. Whether or not you choose to do whatever after is up to you, but it's not contractual, you know, it's not prostitution.
No,
maybe from what you know about escorting, and people out there snapping, but people I know who did escorting, you didn't know they were escorting.
Yes, you don't know when someone's an escort unless they tell you, actually.
Yeah, that's how
a lot of them do it in like when they're students. A lot of them do it when they're students to fund their course, or just like it's just another means of getting money from people. You know, especially nowadays, it's hard for people just to go and get a normal job. So if they can use their talent and their skill, because a lot of time escorting is not about having sex. If they want to do extracurricular activities, then go for it. That's their own business. But the escorting I know is not like that. So I don't know what she's talking about. Yes, go you're a hoe. And if people have sugar daddies, just do you know how much girls have sugar daddies? They don't sleep with them. Not everything's like a Nollywood movie, you know. I know people that get money from men and get things from men, and there's never even so much as a peck like this. Even when the man touches them, they'll flinch. Like, but they still get what they get from him. So what, are they prostitutes now or they're hoes? I don't think so. Talking about society, why don't you talk about what you did and the body modification you did on your own self and see how that makes other people feel about their bodies? Idiot of life. She just talks. I said, I bet you do nonsense. Why isn't this playing? That has a bit of a pause.
Meeting someone who does that and then seeing there's normal. Not that anybody's not normal, but they just live a normal lifestyle.
Yeah.
That's just what they do for work in their spare time. I don't know if I can't judge as acceptable, because one, they were more well off than people I knew were doing decent jobs. And from a moralistic perspective, my mom was like, this is what I'm comfortable doing. I'm making good money doing it. Like who's anybody to tell me that I can't make a living?
You put sugar daddies into perspective, yeah. For me, what comes to my mind is now. You're getting paid because you're gonna sleep with him. That's the way I look at it. If we talk about, hold on. There are sugar daddies that will, in the beginning, because I know quite a few girls that do that, and they've all said the same thing to me. It starts off as they want your company. They've got a family on the side and everything. They're calm. And they'll pay you for your presence, attention.
Some men just do it because they just want to talk. Go to all these Pier 1 and these batch houses, these places. These men just like having a little pretty thing on their arm. So it's very easy for them to pay for their time like that. And then the girls will be feeding them lies. Yeah, I'm a virgin. I want kiss you. And they don't do nothing with them. And they get a lot from these men. So please, about eventually nothing. If a girl doesn't want to sleep with a man, she doesn't have to sleep with him to get anything. These men out here are very stupid. That's why a lot of them are being used. So before you start talking about it's sex, that is not always the case.
Once you even begin talking about, I would even think about going into being an escort. Me and the conversation is already done. Like, we can't go into that direction. Do you know what I mean? So for me personally, I know that women hide it, even though a lot of girls have done it. Like, you think this girl is a church girl, she's proper with everything, and then realistically she's gone and done that job. She may not have slept with the guy, but the fact that she knows that if she brought it into conversation, the conversation for an African man, the conversation is done.
Escorting in itself is not the same as prostitution.
No, it's not. Thank you.
Escorting is paying for your company, your time.
Yes.
Now, what happens behind those doors after is what this generation is kind of prone to, which is, you know,
you're looking a bit rough this week, isn't it?
We've now got this perception that whoever ends up going to Dubai, like, you're going to go and get fucked.
That's my problem.
Actual professional escorts that are actually being paid for their company, and they use that as a skill. It's a skill to be able to interact with many different people, many different backgrounds, do you understand? And that is something that if you're getting paid for it, fine. Do you understand? They don't necessarily need to get paid to have sex with these people.
Yes.
And this is the thing. The people that, like I said, the people that are actually professional escorts, I don't think you'd even know.
Exactly. You wouldn't know. No one goes around going telling everyone, I'm an escort.
Show that they're in the palm.
Oh my God. I've got bogey in my nose, boy. Do you see that?
Whoever is, like, you're from the council block in the East End, but yet you're on a yacht in Dubai. Like, but you've not put no one in the background and you went there by yourself.
You don't snap who you're with.
What's going on here? Do you understand? Questions start getting thrown out. And then all of a sudden the stories come back to the ends and it's like, yo, but you was with some guy that's 85 and you was getting fucked at and there's stuff coming out of you on the plane, or you're just feeling a bit spooky when you get home. That is, you hear these stupid stories that, yo, girls go places, they come back and nothing was the same. Like, you let one old man come all up inside you, and it's the next thing. Here you've got bodies.
Shut up, all these girls, eh? You get in Malaysia, you get in Dubai.
Looks nice there.
You get me? Then you sleep with these old men, with these riches. Get on a plane. We've heard about these stories, innit? Come home, nothing was the same. Stuff is leaking out your fanny. Like, there's supernatural forces that are working against you now. You're not quite the same anymore. Nothing was the same. Life ain't a joke, you know? This life actually ain't a joke.
But my question is, yeah, we have this perception that, oh yeah, like you said, these girls have punished the image. who told you they care about the image? The question is who told you that they're not comfortable going to do what they do?
It might be wrong for you.
That's ratchet. I don't think you should be doing that. I wouldn't let my daughter do that, which is acceptable. But there's a lot of girls, I'm not going to say I know a lot of girls, so I don't, but there are a lot of girls who have a perception in the public eye and don't give two shits about what you think. They'll still go to, you can tell them today, they'll still go to Dubai next week. Don't do it again.
Can I say something as well? Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not really feeling the way you lot are being harsh on the fact that if she's doing escorting, she's a whore. Listen, yeah, there's some people that literally don't have nothing, and that's all they can.
Something, bro.
No, like some people.
No, shut up, Mac. Shut up. Security.
Lack of education. Somebody
wasn't there. Your upbringing is not the same as everyone.
Exactly.
Somebody wasn't there to tell you that you can do better. That's my point. Do you understand? You can.
Shut up. Why do these people always have to bring education and upbringing into everything? You could have a perfect household. Do you know how much people have been brought up with no problems in their household, have literally perfect upbringing, good mum, good dad, been brought up around money, good school, everything they could have asked for, and they still turn to drugs, and they still do things. Not everything all the time is about your upbringing. There's a lot of people that I know that are students that have done it, law students, and brought up in good households, and they've turned to escorting and stuff. And why should that reflect on how they were upbringed? Because they were, it's not, people will make choices that they want to make for themselves. So stop always, they weren't shown the right way, they weren't shown this. And in essa, exactly. So when you was having your body insecurity that you had to go and get your Brazilian butt lift, was that because of you wasn't shown something in your household, or you weren't shown a lack of what? So people are just getting on my nerves. And you, this idiot here. Max, honestly, Maxwell.
You see, when we talk about professional escorts, yeah? For me, the way I look at it is, if you're getting someone to pay you to just for your time, you're a businesswoman.
Amazing.
So I commend you.
Yeah.
Because I'm a businessman. So that's the way I look at it. But once you open your legs, you've gone into a different dimension.
Everyone's talking about, you know, if someone's paying for your time, eventually it's going to end up sleeping with someone. But at the end of the day, like, if he's paying for your time, if that's the agreement you guys have made,
mm-hmm.
I'm not saying I condone it, but I'm just left
with
the situation. Like, there are other ways to make money, yes, but if you've decided to go down that route, you want it to be an escort, it's not prostitution. Do you know what I mean? If you want to go, it's not prostitution,
no,
right? Because he's not sucking breast.
He won't suck your breast. Later.
It's not guaranteed. Excuse me.
I'm quite passionate about me not liking it, full stop. Think it's lazy, think you're just taking a chicken way out.
And you and your bab, why don't you squat?
I have to pay tax. Them people don't need to pay tax. They're taking the easier way out.
That's what I'm saying, being salty.
Yeah, she sounds salty.
There's a lot of salt on that end.
Yes, very.
You
do sound salty.
They're the same people that are on benefit, that are fucking up this whole system.
What?
And then
escorts on benefit. That is a lie. A lot of escorts I know, they're not on benefits, thank you very much. That's rude. That's very rude. She sounds salty. Gogo's right. She's salty, yeah, because people are getting paid for what she's been used for. Men have come and run through Esther and not even bothered to top up their oyster when they're getting on her bus. And because she never got nothing out of it, she doesn't like the fact that people... She can't fathom the fact that people can get so much more from not doing anything. So you have to be a hoe because you have to be doing something. She's one of those narrow-minded women who, like, just because they've been hurt and stuff and they haven't got much from their hurt, the fact that someone can get something more for doing so much less, it will burn them. That's exactly what she's like. Blaming, it's those people on benefits. It's those people on benefits. Benefits, escort wear. When do you ever see that on Channel 5, Benefit Britain? I've never seen that in life.
They're getting paid by uncles to live a certain luxurious lifestyle. It's taking a piss. The reason I'm mad, because about £400 comes out of my...
Told you, salty.
Everyone has a definition. Listen, everyone can define what escorting is. For me, I look at it, if escorting is prostitution, same thing.
No, it's not.
Don't take that away from me. That is my own definition.
You're ignorant. Very ignorant.
You can't stop me from thinking that eventually a man is going to make demands of, once he's taking you out, it's going to come to a stage where he's going to want more. these women that say that they are just escorting for the sake of being there and because.
What did I explain to you like earlier?
Like deep it, honestly. You're going out with this geezer, he's paying for your time, you're telling me eventually he's not gonna want something more. Come on, like we're not, this is not La La Land, let's be realistic. I personally know people that are doing that rubbish.
I feel like there's a lot of energy coming from you, yeah?
Yes.
The question is about the hustle. Your perception of what an escort is what makes it disgusting to you. Shawty, you sound kind of mad. You sound hella the song is there. Like maybe somebody you know been, you know, kind of down that path and has affected you.
I know
a
few people that go down that path.
But this is the rule. Don't be mad. And Shawty just trying to make a living, you know. She's just trying to make ends meet, you know. And not everybody has the means to make a living through 9 to 5. Not everybody has the means to make a living through the norms that we know. You would still get with a guy that does fraud, but he looks like he's going places. Why is that not disgusting to somebody else that is, you are wrong? You ain't paying no taxes. Do you understand? No matter what your hustle is, yeah, like if you have the ethos of what you represent, do you understand? And there's means to an end of what you're doing, yeah, like even if it's wrong, like someone could sort of understand where it's coming from. Do you know what I'm saying? And that's what I use when we're talking about this escort thing. I'm not straight away assuming she's a prostitute.
Yes.
All the women have actually approached me like, yo, you know what? Like, you're actually a very, very dominant man. Like, the way you speak, your demeanor, I like it. I want to be around you. And they've here's an amount. Do you want to come spend time with me? Just buy this. Now, because of my moral values, it's not something I'll do, and it's just a bit weird. Do you get what I'm saying? But there's some people that don't think like that, and they genuinely listen. That's my part-time work. I go out with people, I interact, and in today's society...
Yeah, right. But the way he talks...
In terms of what...
I'm sorry, I disagree with something. You think, because of his moral values, but it's your moral values to be talking to women anyhow. These men definitely undervalue women, and they don't see them for shit. So a woman's telling you she wants to pay you a couple of grand, spend time with her, just spend some time, and then Lucas is like, no, I don't believe that because of my moral values. Don't act like you're a gentleman when you definitely are not a gentleman, threatening to shut people up, and females at that. Please! These men get on my nerves sometimes, you know, honestly.
What your gift is. Your gift might be being able to speak to people, being able to interact with people from many different backgrounds. Do you understand? And it is a form of escorting. Don't automatically assume, because somebody's an escort now, if you look at it in the sense of the way you're saying it, opening your legs and shagging them, man, then yeah, it's dead. Do you understand? Morally and ethically, it's just wrong. Do you understand? But in terms of, like, a woman that knows where she's going, and you know these by people's demeanors and what they stand for, like, she can be classy with the man. Interact, no. It's a form of socializing, really.
Escort, yeah? When I'm first presented with that, I would say, that's an acceptable hustle. Fine, cool. I'm not seeing it Esther's way, though, when I say it's acceptable. I'm seeing it like, cool, we've got together. But when you're answering a question and you really want the true answer, you have to personalize it for yourself. I'm saying it's acceptable hustle. But if my daughter came to me and said, Mum, this is what I want to do, would I tell her yes or no? Hold on. My answer is what I truly think. Now, what I will do myself is different from what I truly believe. A lot of us have crossed lines and done things we thought we would never do. Mm-hmm. Yeah? But the advice we will give to people that we love is what we truly think.
Mm-hmm.
Now ask yourself, if my child came to me, would I say yes or no?
I like Ruby, you know, sometimes.
Even if she's not sleeping with them, your mind will think she's still exposed to a level of, because she's meeting different people, and it could escalate, but she's making money.
Reva, if she dropped 20 stacks on your head, yeah, you would tell her go again.
I said, escorting, I didn't say I disagree with it.
Yeah,
I didn't say that because you made a point about people who can talk, who can be around people, make them happy. If you've got that skill and you can go for it and make them fine. But the reason why I personalize it is so that I can look at the big and deeper picture, because sometimes we focus on what is right in front of us. You're struggling with rent and many other things, but she's come to you and she's giving you a wallop of cash. You take it or you don't take it. You don't take it, you've got red letters coming in and you're facing eviction. What does escorting look like to you at that point?
Yeah.
Before it was bad, now it's okay. Do you see what I mean? So put yourself in those shoes, then you would really get an understanding of what you truly believe about a situation.
Your picture, yeah, is what you see.
My God, look at the quality.
Like the analogy you used. Your picture is what you see. Now, many, all of us in this room are black. Our upbringings, our culture, our ethnicities,
that's better.
Morally doesn't permit that. Do you understand? So we're prone to seeing it like that.
Buffering. I didn't know I was watching it so low. Bloody hell.
I see exactly the same way you just said it. But the reason why I said it the way I said it is because I've grown up with many people that are not like myself. That have not grown up like myself with that moral compass. Their moral
Oh, gosh. Okay. Hello, you don't need to do it twice.
Now, who am I to say that you are wrong for that moral compass? At the end of the day, escorting doesn't mean you're sleeping and shagging everybody that you're going out with.
Yeah. Oh, my God, now you're taking a piss now. Jesus, I wish I never touched it. Oh, my God, this is what's so annoying about doing this on my phone, man. You guys, I can never forget my computer or my laptop ever again. This is just hell. Oh. Seriously.
Two things, yeah. First thing I want to say is just kind of touching off what Reva said and sort of what Gogo was saying about if as a parent, like what would you say to your child? We have to
Terrible, isn't it? Oh,
fuck's sake. There's some mothers that may, their child may come to them and they may think, you know what, you're grinding, you're making money any means necessary, you're doing what you have to do. There's some parents that will think that. They will apply that. If your child is I want you to apply the same moral notion that we're going with to drug dealers that come home with money. Their parents know that they're going out and they're selling drugs in an illegal way that could send them, probably ruin their life, but they are going through poverty. They need the money. So they allow...
Why do they always have these stupid analogies? Jason, listen, let me say something, yeah? A lot of people turn to drugs because it's just easier for them to do that. It doesn't mean that they're going through fucking poverty, so their parents allow it. You can't tell half these people, like, what to do, especially when they're in that sort of field of work with the type of person that they are. If you're not going to get an A-star person in college suddenly go around being a shutter, life doesn't work like that. And those type of people, you can't tell what's wrong or what's right. You know what they're doing. You may not like it. You either shut up about it or you just acknowledge that they're doing it. And that's why they're always so extravagant in their gifts. They're, like, buying their mums this. They're, like, doing that. So that is just how it is. It doesn't mean that they come from poverty. They're always poverty or your upbringing. Not all the time. Not everything is down to fucking poverty and upbringing. Jesus Christ, not Harlem.
So hold on, let me finish. So I think when we're talking about escorting, we need to apply the same moral notion to people that do ACs, to people that drug deals. It's the same, because we're talking about hustles, yeah?
Yes.
So they're all hustles. I think when we're talking about, especially when we talk about, even when I think in my mind...
You can't put it next to fucking AC. That's defrauding people. If someone was to be an escort, then they're going to be an escort, innit? Do you know, there's a lot of things that come under being an escort. Even a chauffeur can be an escort some way, shape or form, you know. In hotels, we go to those posh hotels and they bring you from your car, they take your bags. You're being escorted. So, like, there's so much things that go into escorting, and I wouldn't compare escorting to fucking AC and drug dealers. Even the analogy and the concept of it is all wrong and completely different. Oh, God, these people get on my tits, man. I'm going to fast forward this because I think it's going to keep buffering.
Male escorts and female escorts, automatically my perspectives are different. And this is how society is, because we perceive women differently.
Yes.
In this, they could be doing the exact same job, but society will perceive the woman as, oh, but she might open her legs. No one said that. When we mentioned male escorts, nobody said that. In this room, nobody said, oh, but what if the man's having sex with the woman? Because exactly. If he did, there wouldn't be a problem.
That's true.
If you're going to apply this moral notion of, it's quick money or instant gratification, then you need to apply it across the board. And then you can say, okay, this is all not acceptable, rather than saying, oh, this is acceptable, or, well, but if you do fraud, I'm going to endorse you, even though you're doing the exact same hustle.
Well, you know what, we're not taking in consideration as well, yeah, the word hustle. Like, some people hustle with no means, and some people hustle with a long aim. You never know, this escort could just be escorting for her child. You get what I'm saying? So it depends who you're going with your hustle.
We're saying acceptable hustle. Yeah, you've now defined hustle, yeah? Let's go into acceptable, yeah? Acceptable to who? Who's accepting it? Because, hold on one second. Wait, hold on, let me finish.
First, I said No, I'm not disagreeing with you. I'm saying you defined hustle. Now we have to look at acceptable, yeah? People are saying, is it an acceptable hustle? For it to be acceptable, yeah? You have to assume that the person is subservient to society's views of...
Oh, get a grip. Oh, they always act like this when someone talks, says a big word. Get a grip.
Ridiculous.
You have to assume that they're subservient to society's views of what's acceptable or not. Yeah. The person has to accept it within themselves before anybody else can make pass judgment upon it. What's the difference between them and a stripper? Because some strippers go far and beyond what they're meant to do. What the agreement is, go to the strip club and strip and start fucking man.
Yeah.
So, I mean, then are we going to start looking down a long line of things that are unacceptable, but a lot of people do. Like, I talk to strippers, we make five... Like, I'm going to talk about Americans because that's people I know. American strippers who make $500 a night, and they pay for everything in their life, in their livelihood that they could ever have wanted in life. Are you going to now turn around and say, no, you can't make $500 like that because it's wrong? Like, they're doing what they know and they're good at.
Max, what?
For someone that their line of work is uncomfortable for you, I don't understand. If someone's making a living doing something and they are harming somebody else and it's legal, I'm so sorry, you can't tell them how to or how not to make their own money. Like, there are strippers who make five times what people make working 60-hour weeks.
Yeah.
And they're happy doing what they're doing. If they're comfortable with it, who are you to go and tell them that they can't make money the way they
yeah.
make money? That's their business.
Yeah.
You need them to do what they're doing.
Let's look at it from this perspective, yeah. When I used to do certain things before,
yeah.
And I'll bring money home directly, like
yeah.
what Sia said, yeah. I'll bring money home to my mum and I'll tell her, mum, here's the money
yeah.
for the gas, the electricity, for the month, yeah, you don't even need to complain anymore.
Yeah.
What she'll say to me, and all Africans, so we can all relate, she'll say to me, thank you for bringing the money, but the way you got the money, do you understand?
Oh, this boy, not all Africans.
So I don't want to use that money
yeah.
because her morals are telling her that something will happen because I'm feeding her from other people's addictions. Do you understand? Wait, hold on. Let me finish,
man.
I'm feeding her from other people's addictions.
Yeah.
Do you understand? So there's some kind of spiritual repercussions
okay.
there. Do you understand? The question I wanted to pose to everyone is anyone being harmed,
yeah.
right, from the money that's being made? Is anyone being harmed in the process?
Yeah.
Because it's a hustle.
Yes.
Yeah. The question I'm posing now,
yeah.
because obviously Esther's saying that it's disgusting.
Okay.
Yeah, so is anybody being harmed in that process? Am I being harmed as a male escort or is the person...
This is what I'm trying to say to you.
It might be the morality of the situation, it might be the legality of the situation, but she's unsure about something. Yeah. So what I'm trying to say to you is, if something is 100% legal, which like it's not illegal to be an escort, then all you've got left is morality. So in that sense, nobody can be harmed in that sense because... Like you're allowed to do it. No one said don't do it.
Yeah.
Whether you're comfortable accepting whether someone does it or not.
There's a difference, like doing something out of choice, by choice, and doing something because you have to do it. Like, obviously, let's forget how she got herself in this predicament, but she's in this predicament.
Why is it a predicament? What if she just wanted to be a fucking escort?
Nobody can help her, and she's been presented...
Still a profession, to be honest.
You know, with this opportunity to escort. For example, you have responsibilities, Esther, yeah? Say, God, you have education, you have all of that. But say you had none of that, right? You have a daughter to look after. You have no other way of making money than to escort. What would you do? Let your child starve? That's my point. That's why you can't condemn it just like that. I am not as judgmental as I may come across. I feel like people end up in professions that they haven't necessarily planned to be in,
yeah.
so we can't really condemn it. Like, as long as you're doing something and your end goal is to get out, like drug dealing, stripping or whatever, you have to do it because you have to make ends meet.
Yes, as long as you have an ending goal of getting out.
As long
yes.
as you're not necessarily doing it for the sake of doing it and doing it for the fun of it.
If they're doing it for the fun of it, still, who cares?
You have to, like,
okay.
respect everybody's hustle as long as they
My
see
business.
A way out.
You're talking almost as if, like, to be an escort, you have to open your legs and shag something.
Nobody's saying that, Lucas.
So then, what are we talking about then? An escort is... There's nothing wrong with being an escort then.
I do not condemn it, but I will not do it. That's not the path I want to go down, but...
If your girl told you she was an escort before, would you even... Would she be your girl?
Okay, I like that question you asked me. I'm going to ask it perfectly. Me personally, because of my perception of how I view girls, how I view women, I wouldn't accept it. You know why?
Yeah.
Because of how I've grown up. I'm more cultured than most. And you always talk about, you know, change and this and that. The way the world has changed today, yeah? People get paid.
I tell you something, like, hear me out. I just think this chat's shit. I think he's not doing it because how he views women. He wants to make it like he sees women as queens. It's obvious he doesn't see women as much with the way he interacts with them on this show. So let's just put that aside. Let me tell you something, yeah, a man like this, if you were to have a secret, yeah, and be with a man like this, and say that, tell him that you used to be an escort, I don't think he would leave you. No, he wouldn't. He's talking because he's talking in front of everyone else. But he will never, ever, ever make you forget that you was an escort. And in arguments, he will demean you so much. He will tell you, he will always bring up, you slut, who are you going to go sleep with? The way he talks, and it will come out so even more horrible than I could even say it. So, yes, he would still be, but he would never let someone forget that you was an escort. He would never let you forget it. So, please, he's a liar.
To talk on TV. People get paid for many different things that our parents would be like, how can you go and do that? What I'm saying is, there's a difference between being an escort, getting paid for talking to people, and being paid to prostitute yourself. Open your legs and shack, talk to people. So what do you do? You can do more than that. I can pose as your partner as well. What's wrong with you? Don't you know?
Where's your point, Max? Nobody's sleeping with anybody. Yeah,
if I'm posing...
What I think Max is saying is, how would he even know if the girl slept with the person? Because you would only tell people what you want to tell them. I could say I was an escort, but I never had sex, and I could have been having sex, but I don't need to divulge that information to you, so how do you know? So basically, if you're going to excuse the fact that, yes, I used to be an escort and talk to people, then you have to be open to the fact that they could have possibly done more if you're going to accept that. That is true. It comes with the territory. There's some people that will probably do more. Maybe the man says, oh, a little 10 grand, let me just a little one night. And that girl will probably be like, you know, 10 grand. Maybe it's something she only did once, but hey, that's what she did. But does she have to tell you that information? How do you know that she never slept with anyone? Because she told you she just spoke to people. Some people are just naive, man. If you're going to accept something, then you have to accept it. You can't pick and choose what you choose to accept. Otherwise, you just don't accept it at all.
If I'm posing as your partner, it may need for me to do certain things that partners do in the midst of people. It's not only about sex. If my girl has told me that she was posing as the next man's girl and she had to lips him and all these things, already I'm uncomfortable. I don't want to hear it.
Do you know what I've realised, yeah? Lucas is like a watered-down version of an alpha male. And the reason I say that is because a man said escorting is okay to do, not remembering that a man has sisters. Not remembering that he's going to have a girl or he has a girl. And the question in question now is, are you going to let your girl do that job, knowing that there's a possibility she's going to off the pan? That's what he needs to begin to think about.
We understand that people hide under the title escort and are being a prostitute. They're sleeping with people. That's the difference. But if you're an escort, you're going to give your time to somebody. You're just appearing in places. You're not sleeping with the person. I don't know. The person that's sleeping with you is ripped. If you haven't consented to it, then they're raping you. Mm-hmm. You should go and report to the police.
Woman,
I meet you and you say I want to pay you for sex and I say, sure, cool. That's illegal. I can do that. Can I say you can do that? You can pay me for sex.
So this means you have to put it out there, right?
If you come up to me and you say, I will give you £100 to have sex with me tonight, and I say, cool, that's my legal.
How am I gonna do that if I don't know your
prostitution? Men do it all the time. I am very passionate that escorting is the same as prostitution. Because for me, I know of people who they sleep with that person. Today's the first time I'm hearing, well, maybe not the first time, but I'm hearing you.
She's a fucking liar. She didn't say that in the beginning. She never knew girls that sleep with people. She's putting her own suspicions and coming up with 18 when she's meant to just be sticking to 1+1.
And actually just sit down and chill and talk. For me, I'm still struggling to believe that, because from what I know of and the people that I know of that do it, mate, they are beaten, they're chopped. So that's why I'm very passionate.
You don't know. You're assuming.
Like, well, there's people that sit there and they just talk. I'm baffled because from what I know, bruv, you're sitting down, you're talking, you're beating, you're getting good, you're getting...
Because that's something that she can't do. Do you know what? You have to look at the way sometimes people think, and the way people you have to analyze people's answers sometimes. And it's only, she can't see that because it's not something that she can do with a human being without it being an escort. She can't just sit down and talk. They have to be. That's exactly, her mentality is like that. That's why she can't see no one else being able just to sit down and talk with someone and get money without having to do anything sexual, because she can't do that. So that means everyone else that does that and for money, you're a hoe. So she's not saying it logically, like logically thinking. She hasn't got a leg to stand on because she's not talking sense. She's basing everyone else on her own values for her own self. Because you can't do it doesn't mean that someone else can't. And you just hate the fact that it's crazy to you that someone can actually do that because you can't and get money for it when you can't do that. Jealous, are we? Look at her, salty boots.
And all of this shit.
Exactly. Exactly.
Just crazy. This generation, banging is nothing.
Yes.
So imagine someone's giving you cash, and then they give a little, okay, let's do something fine in the corner. I'm not saying it's 100%, but let's be real with ourselves, yeah? Real life, real people, real talk. The likelihood of them opening their lips is very high. And that's why when you start escorting, it's more likely that you can end up there. So sometimes life, yeah, it's not just about how you start, it's about how you end.
Yes.
That's where it's important. So if you want to start doing escort 1212, that's,
yes.
That's what I'm saying, the dodginess is it. Not that it's wrong, but it can lead you,
yes,
somewhere.
A lot of girls have slept with a number of guys, haven't had no significant gain from it, yeah? Had their heart broken, the guy doesn't give them no money, doesn't even pay for cab for them to go home, don't buy them food, if most, maybe £2.50 chicken and chips. Then you see someone coming to you where they're asking you for the same thing that guy got back
uh-huh.
asked you for, but they're willing to give more.
Mm-hmm.
Girls will jump at the
yes.
opportunity because
and
in the
yes.
position where
I know a
they're
lot
doing
that
more for less, and now they're doing less for more.
And that's why Esther is pissed.
Girls aren't going into it.
We've understood what escorting is. We understand what prostitution is. We've also understood that people go under escorting to prostitute as well. Yeah. So these are all here. Cool. So let's keep that to one side. Let's just bring it right back down to London, yeah? Finesse chicks. Just putting it out there, innit? Girls that will go out with certain guys, go and live the lavish lifestyle, and I'm not opening legs, they're twanging every man they come across. Is a finesse chick an escort? So, again, when we're talking about the escorting thing and saying eventually they'll open leg, let's say that this girl is a finesse chick. And let's say that she has gone and done contracted hours to say, you know what, you want me to make you look good and feel good, we go out, we do this and do that, that's fine. But if you think you're sleeping with me, you played yourself. And the men understand that. So let's say that is the contract that they've set in place. Regardless of whether she has a child or she doesn't. Let's say she's trying to pay bills. Let's say she's not trying to pay bills. Let's say she's trying to look for a job, can't find nothing, don't want to go job center. She's saying, fuck it, this is what I'm on. And she makes that contract that, look, I speak to you, I go out, I rub your earlobe and shit like that, but that's it. We're not fucking. Is she then a prostitute or is she a professional escort? What is she? Because we've come to this borderline thing where it's like, if you're doing this, eventually it's this. All right, cool. That's a very big extreme, though.
Yes.
When we're talking about is it acceptable for our children to do it, you're looking at a different thing. You're saying it's acceptable, but for my children to do it, it's not acceptable. Let's say, for example, someone's paying for your time.
Thank you.
You've got people that are on the phone that do that whole sex talk thing.
Yes.
And they get paid for that. Is that?
I tried doing that once. Oh, terrible.
So let's say you go and pick up the phone. Oh, babe, you're doing this, you're rubbing yourself. Yeah, it feels good. You're doing
you like that.
We're not saying that the conversation's about sex. Let's say that the person's like some old dude and he just wants company.
Yeah.
He's got some wifey issues or some shit. He just wants affection. And he's sitting there, you just talk to the nigga.
Yeah.
He's there, oh, how are you, right? Da 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 da, whatever. You don't have no sexual conversation whatsoever. But I'm saying, let's say that you're saying that is wrong. So what if you're on the phone and you actually are having a sexual conversation and you're paying for that and that's your hustle? What about that then?
I think it boils down to morals. Like, what you will find morally acceptable and what I may find morally acceptable will be two different things. For me, morally, it's not acceptable. All rounder.
Let's say that you've got a woman there, you've got two women, you've got two guys there, and they're speed dating. And one person's there saying you can pay for me, you'll pay for my time, but we're not having sex. And you've got another girl that comes in when the bell dings and she's like, psh, listen, what you pay for is what you get. So if you want this, pay for the box. You get me? We're at it. and you do it. I'm saying, so what is wrong? Is it the act of you doing it regardless of whether you're having sex or not, you put yourself in that position, or is it the long-term mentality of what you've got ahead of you?
It's not acceptable to do such things. Obviously, now, today, people are doing it regardless. But the reality is, people are doing it on a D-low. No one's coming out and saying, yo, I'm an escort. Yo, I do this. Yo, I do that. Before, it was a secret. Now, because people are now coming out with it and are willing to do it, now people are feeling more comfortable.
Where is she getting this from? I don't know anyone that is an escort and open about it, unless you watch documentaries and stuff. But you don't, I've never in my lifetime come across someone and I've asked, what do you do? And they've openly said, oh, I'm an escort. I mean, I found out people are, and, like, that's another conversation. It's like, oh, my God. But I've never seen, I don't know where she's getting this, where people are open, don't care about it, like... How do you know that there's not with rich men that wanted that are spoiling them, the shit out of them, you know? It doesn't necessarily mean that they're escorts that you're seeing. She does seem a bit bitter about something, boy. This is more than disliking, I'm telling you.
A part of your lifestyle? Then why won't you come out with your chest and say, listen, I'm an escort? Because you know you're being a hoe. It is nasty. You are a hoe. Because you...
It's not... So who's going to want to tell the whole world? Do you know how people frown on? Exactly why people wouldn't come out. It's exactly how, why would someone come out and say something when she, look what she's saying on camera. You're all hoes. So if you're already putting that out there, why should someone feel the need to have to come out and say that they're an escort if this is already what you're deeming them as a hoe? Dummy.
The reality, all jokes aside, it's not a positive thing. You can't go to your mum and say, listen, mum, what job do you have, darling? Mum, I'm an escort. Like, really? Like, you know it's not right. Sometimes it's not even about what you find acceptable. It's about what you feel is comfortable. Because certain things can be totally acceptable and still make you feel very uncomfortable.
Yes.
The idea of escorting, where we're talking to a stranger, the idea of it for me as a person makes me very uncomfortable.
Yes.
I don't like interacting intimately with people I don't genuinely get along with, people I don't really hit off with. So for me, the idea, the whole idea of it is very uncomfortable. The thought of my daughter doing it or my sister doing it makes me very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Now, if I met a woman my age, perfectly sane, seems like a lovely woman, goes about her business, don't bother no one, she's living a good life, all of them things there, and she comes to me and she says, yo, I'm an escort, I'm going to be curious, I'm going to be interested.
Yeah, same here, I was curious when I found out.
Oh, you do that, because I don't mean...
Yeah.
But for me to say it, I would find it unacceptable.
Yeah.
I don't really think it's got anything to do with whether or not I accept...
Thank you! It's no one's business.
Why does something like, why does it matter like whether I find something like that?
Yes!
I think, yeah, I'll be honest with you, I think this is, it's a biased conversation. The reason I say that here, it's because all conversation long, we've been talking about, if a woman goes out and does this year. I can't lie to you, I don't know anyone here if they saw, even you girls are saying it's unacceptable, I don't know anyone here if they saw a male escort that's going to feel a bit funny.
Yes.
I'm not gonna lie to you. If you look, I, that's my personal opinion. That's how I feel. If you saw an older woman take a young guy out, not like young, but like middle-aged guy out, like, I don't think you'd find it as disgusting as if you saw an old man take a young woman.
Yes.
I feel like, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying it's fair or right, but I feel like there's some obvious reasons why people look at women escorting differently. I feel like probably it's possible. People feel like women are more vulnerable, men are stronger, that kind of thing. They're more dominating. They also feel like when it comes to that kind of dynamic, a lot of young girls can be very naive when it comes to that as well. When
but
and how bad that can be.
No one's thinking at that. No one's
so
thinking that.
What you guys are saying,
it's just the way the world is. It's sexist. No, you don't always need to be bringing this your Oxford Dictionary to fucking debates all the time. We all know you're intelligent, babe. We don't need to keep slamming all of this analogy down our fucking throats. No one is thinking that. It's just plain sexism. That is what it is. That is how it is. And it's from a lot of women to each other as well. As you see with Esther, she's going so hard, but when everyone's talking about a man doing it, she shuts up her mouth. So it's right in front of you. It's just how it is. That's just how people... Any girl that does it is a hoe. Anyone does it is a hoe. She never once implemented a man doing escort. This question wasn't aimed at a specific sex or gender. It was a general question. And everyone's turning it into a woman, a female, all the time. Woman, female, female. It's just the way their world is. Everyone always wants to be sexist when it comes to a woman. Don't understand it. Even women are being sexist to women. Look at Esther. Man, you're giving this whole dictionary. Why don't you look at the person next to you? That is your dictionary.
What, how much you're giving away, how much you're selling.
I think
usually, there's plenty of people people. Now, I feel like there's plenty of people who do it who aren't, like, desperate. But it's just kind of like, okay, you know, this is a good way, it's quick money, it's good, whatever, whatever,
yes.
Right? But more historically in the past, socially, it's the more marginalised and the more deprived and the more vulnerable people that end up in those kind of institutions. And so until those kind of stigmas get washed away, we're automatically going to associate certain things.
What our parents did for us, they know that they did it because they didn't have a choice, for example. So that's why they did certain things. But they try and give us, they pave the way for us for not to do those things, if that makes sense. But if we choose to, it's a decision on us.
Yes.
Some people shot and they give the piece to their mum. Their mum knows where the dough is coming
yes.
from, but it's helping at the time.
Yes.
It's not justifiable, it makes it a good thing, but every hustle is different for your reason.
Yes.
If you're hustling because you want to go put a big H belt on your waist, then you're very silly. But if you're going to go and hustle and get a gun and give it to your mud or invest it even,
yes.
you're doing what you have to do to get
yes.
it, so you have to not do that anymore.
Yes.
What was the norm for our parents is different to the norm for us today. What will be the norm for us today is going to be the different norm for our children. So what our parents couldn't condone, we do. And they're like, how can you go and do that, and it's a norm for us, do you understand? And the things that we are going to do, our children, and we're even seeing as young as we are now, the younger ones coming up, we're like, from in my day, them things Denver used to run, do you understand?
And can I say something?
I just want everyone to think of that before you say, this is wrong, this is unacceptable, do you understand?
I personally feel like, with escorting now, of course there are women who do that. You see is what you get. You tell me you want my time, I give you my time, you give me money. That's where it begins and ends. But I feel like now escorting is basically a way people have clocked prostitution is lucrative. It gives them money. It's illegal to solicit. You can't do that. Prostitution back in the day was for people who were desperate, majoritively, yeah? It was for people who needed money, who needed a fix, who were living on the streets, people who were so down and out. Now, you're not getting these women that are missing teeth, that smell hair falling out. Now that the way they've repackaged it, you're getting these nice women, you're getting bad, you're getting, amen.
Can I say something?
Yeah, I'm not finished, sorry. So they're getting these lovely women, and so now they're really getting the big bucks. So for us to sit here and be like, oh no, escorting isn't that. Escorting is prostitution for me, majoritively repackaged. Now it's nice and shiny and it's new and it's fresh and it's attractive and people want to do it. And I just feel like, if we're going to be honest about that aspect, then most people won't find that acceptable.
Even this escorting is even, I'm getting irritated. Now, let's get back to basics, yeah? In 2017, let's get into 2017. Now, the reason I'm very, very passionate about this whole situation is because all of this escorting, it is all the same thing. There are girls that are in university, there's nothing wrong at home, they're living comfortably
yeah.
at home, but they want to live beyond their means. Part of living beyond their means, rather than getting a job, like, normal people would, they would rather go to an uncle, sugar daddy, or go and live that luxurious lifestyle. Let me finish, huh?
That's a job.
Okay, whatever. I don't care. Whatever. But whatever they call it, I don't care. But that's what they would rather do. For me, that's where my problem is, because at the end of the day, for example, I was going to book a holiday to Dubai. It comes with a stigma. I was going to book a holiday to Dubai. How can my friend say to me, oh, who's sponsoring your trip? What do you mean who's sponsoring my trip? Because there's so many girls out there who, it's not about because they're poor at home.
Yeah.
Or they're finding it hard to make ends meet. It's because they want to live a certain lifestyle. And part of that lifestyle is to, rather than go out and get a good job, they want to, they're just lazy. And for me, it pisses me off.
Let's now differentiate between the escorts. We've already spoke about, you know.
She kind of had a point there.
The professional escort. Now, let's bring it back to Black London. Let's not talk about general,
but not
let's
all.
Talk about Black London and the stigmas that follow, like you said, a lady booking a trip to Dubai, a lot of my babes in Nige this year in the Christmas period, you know, and my real uncles are showering them with beauties. You know what I'm saying? Let's bring it back to the gospel. You know what I'm saying? Let's talk about LDN. So 2016 December, it was like, no, 2016 December,
Ghana, Nigeria, especially, it was epic and rife with London women who, even if you know, do you know Lekon in Nigeria? Do you know Kwame in Accra? Why are you there? Okay, cool, you go to experience a holiday. Now, the problem with that is the stigma that the women that go there that actually do the, let me Millie rock on one uncle and back it up for OG because he's about to shower me with that paper. Because at the end of the day, it's the good life. Again, me, Morido, I knock it because my wife can't end up like that. But if you want to be a bad view and you own your shit and you want to go to Ghana, Nigeria and bust it open and crack it wide. what? By all means.
A lot of girls went to Ghana, Nigeria last year, 2016, innit? You went there for Christmas, innit? You went there to do New Year's, innit? Turn up, innit? Why are you turning up, though? Who do you know there, though? Your mum's here. Your dad's here. Family's here. Christmas is with family.
But what's your business, anyway? It's not your business, is it? Why are you so bothered? If someone, if they want to go there, turn up with those men, who cares?
They can give you nice finances to come back home and do 6 months, then you go back again.
The question I'm going to pose to everyone is, when things happen from, like, we talk about back in the day and the future, some things happen that are taboo in a society, and then later on they become slightly more acceptable. Do you guys think that this whole process of girls going abroad, getting paid for it, do you think that it's a taboo in our generation now that's going to become a little more acceptable as time goes on?
If you look back at our grandparents or so forth, if you can even go further, it's something that's been ongoing. They take, like, if you're from a poor family, take your mum to go marry some rich uncle across in the city. So that nature's always been there, you know, a woman kind of going to a man in a time of need. But like Ezra saying, it's been changed now, it's been polished, and yeah, it's become more acceptable.
You lot are actually being a bit too harsh, like, because some people literally go to Africa, go Caribbean, etc., and not doing what you lot are saying.
Yes.
Like, what about them lot?
Yes.
Hold on.
You're generalizing. Yes, they are generalizing. I feel like she's aiming this at a lot of black girls, and I think people are saying, who's sponsoring your trip? Because when you associate Dubai, you think Arab, you think money, you think, oh my God, you think, like, so I don't necessarily think that it's a bad thing that people think that you're sponsored, that someone sponsored your trip. I don't think so. I just think that, you know, just take it as it is. Why are you taking that to heart for? Like, who cares if that's what people think? Good for them. You're paying your trip with your own money, so... Like, I don't understand, it's not, I don't think it's a stigma of people using people. I think, when I think of Dubai, I think of the rich and famous and rich Arabs going there and stuff. Like, so it's just like, it's not, I will never think of escorting or anything like that. So I don't know why they're associating escorting with Dubai and places like that. Because personally, I wouldn't think that. Dubai ain't even that expensive to go to anyway. It's not like it's fucking Hawaii, like a £2,000 ticket to go there. So please, get a grip, Esther.
What?
More time I blame girls, because it's the girls that are actually doing that. It's not even us.
What you just said, to me, that doesn't even make sense. But they have an employer. Their employer is a man. Hold on, wait, let me finish. Your employer is a man. If the man was not showering her with that, she would have no employer. There is a two-way thing. You cannot put the whole responsibility onto a woman. My ability, it doesn't make sense. Listen to what I'm saying. My ability to be able to do that, to be able to finesse, to be able to start, to be able to go somewhere and live off a man, comes from his hand. That's
yes.
What I'm trying to say. Do you know what I'm trying to say? It comes from his hand. If he doesn't release his hand, then I'm not able to eat from that hand. Not to say that you should do that. Of course, it comes down to choice. What I'm saying is, you also need to place some responsibility onto the men that are doing this.
Yes.
A one-sided thing. And I think it's always happening in society. Things get misconstrued and we put 100% of the responsibility
on the woman.
A woman.
Yes.
We also need to realize,
like Esther.
We also need to realize there are young women that have been abused as kids.
Yes.
They've been taken advantage of. They are naive. They are living in a certain way. There are men that are more mature, that know what they are doing.
Yes.
That intelligently are doing this to manipulate young girls.
Yes.
I've just got a story I want to quickly share.
Oh, God, give me a break with the stories.
This guy gave me two bags. Hold on. He gave me two bags. I said, yeah. Let me get there. Now. The guy said to me after, babe, you know what, if you want to get your breast done and your bum done, I'll cover it. You know, we're talking about 12 bags here. That's when I ran, because I realised, hold on.
Did you run with the 2000?
No.
I would have taken the 2000 and given him receipt.
Let me finish. The talk about surgery came after the
Esther?
Generally speaking, you have so much power in your hands. Now let me put it to you guys like this, innit? From sightings to escorts to prostitution, all of this would not exist if women just said no. I understand that there are things that are happening that may make you sway into that direction. But if you stand up and say no is no, no guy will be there will be no girls to sleep with, number one. No, there will be no sightings. In fact, you have guys doing what you want them to do. Hold on. If only you said no. So for me personally, I don't think you can even make the guy accountable, because he's worked hard. He has enough peace to splash everywhere. Like Gogo was telling me a couple hours ago, there's 4 African billionaires that can just solve all our problems. The money's there, bro. But it's up to you whether you say no or you say yes. So the onus is on you. The onus is on you guys.
It all boils down to earning your own shit. Do you know what I mean? Like, earning it. Like, if you're not throwing it back on old guys, if you like collecting money and give blah, 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 that's you. Like, at the end of the day, each to their own. Do your thing. I don't condone it, but don't hide under being an escort. For going down to the definition of an escort, that's not prostitution.
This actually gets on my nerves, like, when I think about it, because we're in a world right now where women are at the top of the chain, women power, feminists everywhere, running around with their little bras, do you know what I mean? But in reality, you don't look inside of yourself, seeing the mistakes that you make. Do you understand? If women were just to say, look, I'm not opening my legs, then guys wouldn't be sleeping with anyone.
Yes.
That simple science.
Yes.
This I could have learned from back in my country, is simple. Just don't open your legs, nothing will happen. You open your legs, more time, you become a hoe.
If I'm offering you money, you have a choice to take.
Stop that. More time you become a hoe. Then why do men stop promising women stuff that they're not able of capable of doing? So now this is down. Now this one subject has made it down to women and not opening. I was with him for a certain aspect until he said, you know, you have to be opening legs makes you a hoe. And what about the idiotic men that want to lie and be foolish to women and tell them this and tell them that, and then after, when they get what they get, then they go. And what, that girl is still a hoe because she believed a man's words. Idiot. You're a fool. Jesus, you keep talking and you prevent yourself from getting any pussy, Max.
I'm not saying because I have an abundance of something and I want to do something. You now say, oh yeah, well, this is now a two-way thing. It's not a two-way thing. I don't have a problem with paying you or servicing you or paying for your service or paying for your fanny or whatever. I don't see anything wrong with that. So it's not a two-way thing. You have a problem with it. Or whoever stigmatizes it has a problem with it. So if that is the case, then say no. Do you understand? If you ain't going to say no, then that's where I agree with Joma. And what the problem is a lot of women, it's, why am I not wife for you? But you forget that you've done stuff that morally me, I can't take. Yes, it might be acceptable for you, and I can understand that. There's plenty of things that are understandable, and we can be like, you know what? Yeah, cool, that makes sense. But to me, it makes sense. Like, sometimes
And why is it always on the woman for her? Why is it always being brought up for a woman that she, why is she not wifey? But why is it always questions for the woman? What about a man? Why aren't you someone's husband yet? Don't anyone think of that? It doesn't only take a one person to make a relationship, you know. Why aren't you a husband yet? Why aren't any of those people there married? Why? They're like talking so much about women and all of this, and you're not wifey material. If you do this, you're a hoe. Then where is this your own wife then, seeing as you like talking? Where's your partner? Here talking, telling me shit.
They're okay where they are, but they want more. Like, for example, I know people that are living in...
I bet you do.
Flat, for example, they're sharing with their brother and sister, like, but yet they're driving a 16-plate... Mercedes Benz. I'm not trying to be funny. If it's to better your life, you wouldn't be trying to do lifestyle with it. They're in university, but because they just want to, they want to carry that Louis Vuitton bag, they want to drive a Mercedes plate, they want to be a part of a lifestyle. The people that I know are full-time escorters. They're going, they're traveling five, they're prostituting. People that hustle and they invest in it, I respect them for it.
thank God that's fucking over. I'm getting on my fucking nerves. Jesus, the same ignorance like always. All the time ignorant. Well, you guys, let me know what you thought of this episode down there. I just get to my nerves how one topic just led to all of these avenues. They can never just stick to the fucking topic. Because if they ever did, these videos would never need to be this fucking long. They just go all here and everywhere, contradict themselves, come back to the point. Contradict themselves, come back to the point. Contradict themselves, come back to a point. Jesus Christ. To the point where, like, I don't understand it. All these happens because women just don't say no. If you just close your legs and say no. Do you know, life is not that black and white when someone's lying to you in front of your face and taking you for granted, acting like they want something more. Because if you're going to talk about that, then you have to talk about the heartbreak that people go through and the way people get taken for granted and the way people get used. And obviously, if you like someone and you're in a certain place and they're telling you this and they're making you feel certain things, it's only natural as an adult that you're going to have sex, or you're going to have sexual relations with that partner, with the person that you see yourself with or you think is going somewhere. It's normal to do that. So just because that you might not do that, what does that, just because that you now have sex with that person or you meet someone else and they do that to you again and you meet someone else and do that to you again, how is that your fault and how does that make you a hoe because you opened your legs thinking it's going to be something that it's not? Because if you want to take this somewhere, you can't make you can't put a statement out there like that and not expect other answers and questions. Not everything is just black and white, you know. Don't sit here and start questioning and then you got this stupid idiot of wifey material. When was you someone's husband? Tired of these people, man. You got this Ezra, Isaiah, whatever, giving her the Oxford dictionaries while you've got someone who's blatantly ignorant right next to you who actually could be the example of everything you're trying to say. So stop. Why is it women? It's women because it's just how it is. It's not because of no back in the day. No one thinks about that. I never grew up back in the day thinking about escorts and prostitution being any type of way. So shut up and speak for yourself. Don't put that on how we think for ourselves, because that's just nonsense. It's just the way people choose to see things. Everyone's an individual. And that's how Esther is how a lot of girls will how a lot of girls will undermine a lot of women that are doing well. And what is annoying, because Esther, she's the biggest contradiction in this whole episode, because how she's saying how she doesn't like someone telling her, or who do you think you are asking me if I'm someone who's sponsoring my trip, like how does she know for sure that the people that she says that she knows that are escorts are not just getting money and hustling on their own, that no one's doing nothing for them, seeing as she knows. So don't assume that just because you see someone having a new car or having a Louis Vuitton bag, that it's because they're escorting and they're sleeping with people. Some people got their own private hustle. Some people maximize credit cards, you know. Some people get loans and get themselves in fucking debt for the nicest things. I'm not saying that it's right, but you can't just assume that just because you see people in those situations that everyone's an escort, and that just because they're an escort, they're sleeping with the people. And just because you slept with someone for money, it doesn't make you a prostitute if you've done it once or twice in my book. It doesn't. It really doesn't. It actually doesn't. So, and who is anyone else to judge? Why don't you concentrate on your own business? I'm not as Ezra, because I met someone I didn't know. I was asking, I was like, because he does a lot. And I always said to myself, oh my God, what do you actually do? Because I knew that that wasn't just McDonald's money, because he worked in McDonald's, worked in Primark. And he told me he's an escort. And I was like, I kind of had an inkling that something like that, because it's kind of common in the gay community. But I was just like, I was more curious. I was asking questions. He's like, oh my God, you should do it. They'll pay a lot for your body. I was like, no. That's when I found it disrespectful. Because that's something, that's that's different. Like, you don't convince someone or try and persuade people to get into that type of work. No, you don't do that. But I wasn't mad about it. I just knew that it's not someone I'd be associating myself with too tough, because I mean, you know. But it doesn't mean I didn't look at him any less. I was like, you know, go for you. But it's true, if you're doing something like that, you can't do it forever. There has to be like an ending goal. You have to be wanting to invest in something. So that I agree with. But still, it's just, these people are so biased and just ignorant, man, honestly. But yeah, we shall see for next week. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below.